In this unit, you will be presented with a list of the required materials for the Bargue technique, from how big your drawings should be, the types of charcoal and paper you should be using, to the function of each specific material presented. You may choose between drawing with charcoal or with pencil. If you prefer pencil, you should have a selection of well-sharpened pencils, 2H through 2B. The original Bargue course was designed for charcoal, so I recommend it over pencil. You will need a full-size plate printed in high quality to 60 by 40 centimeters. Drawing this large forces you to get over the fear of arm movements to express controlled outcomes. If you choose to work in pencils, then print it A3 size. Paper for charcoal. Make sure it is acid-free, pH neutral, or even slightly alkaline. High cotton content, with some tooth and a well-sized surface that can take much erasure. Vine or willow charcoal, thin sticks. Nitrum charcoal, B, HB, and H. Compressed charcoal. Pencil extender. Sanding block or a sheet of 400 grit sandpaper. Laser level or a simple plumb line. Masking tape. Metal skewer. I recommend a length of about 40 centimeters. Vertical easel with a MDF board measuring 60 by 100 centimeters. Ruler should be long, at least 50 centimeters. Small flat mirror, neither concave nor convex. Small black mirror. The screen of a smartphone is good as long as it's turned off. Fine permanent pen and a large sheet of acetate, the same size as the plate. Putty eraser, a pencil eraser, and an electric eraser. Workable matte fixative. Do not use hairspray, as it contains chemicals that will affect the drawing long term. Optional materials. Paper stumps, also known as tortillons, and soft makeup brushes. Hard brushes. Chamois cloth, good for smudging and erasing charcoal. Powdered charcoal, will give a softer look when toning large areas. Empty container to store charcoal dust in. Deep green sunglasses. The color must be saturated of a strong green. Mole pole to keep your hand steady. Mask to protect yourself from charcoal dust. The book, Charles Bargue Drawing Course, by Gerald Ackerman and Graydon Parrish. If you are a beginner, you should have a selection of well-sharpened pencils, 2H through 2B. Remember that soft B pencils tend to create distractingly shiny surfaces. You will need a kneadable eraser. Electric erasers are really good with graphite. Pencils cannot achieve the same density of darkness as in the plates. Notice how charcoal is matte and much darker. If you use pencils, strive instead for overall lighter shadows and light halftones, as darkening more than that will create an undesirable metallic surface. Work most of your shadows with HB and only use the B or 2B sparingly, as they are very shiny, and only for the tones that HB cannot render. In the light areas, use only H and 2H. For a traditional looking paper, Fabriano Artistico is great for charcoal, as it is very strong and work can be easily erased. Another great paper is Strathmore 500 charcoal, because of its beautiful light texture, very close to Ingres papers, similar to the texture of most of the sheets sold in the 19th century. For a rougher and more experimental paper, I recommend the smoother side of Moulin de la Roque Colombe 600. As it is almost impossible to erase marks on this paper, it should only be used by more advanced students. In despite of its pronounced texture, you can blend with a softer brush. And with the hard brush, you can achieve a surprisingly even texture for such a rough paper. My favorite sanded paper is UART pastel paper, for the Bargue plates that don't rely too much on fine line drawing. This paper is ideal for broad areas of shading with charcoal. It's available in different grades of roughness. Surprisingly, I found the rougher grades easier to control than the finer, especially when it comes down to erasing mistakes. Vine charcoal and willow charcoal, thin sticks. Hold the stick with a gentle hand to prevent breakage. In here, we are looking at charcoal being applied over Lanaquarelle rough paper. My vine charcoal is slightly harder than my willow and creates a finer texture and line. Depending on the brand, vine charcoals tend to be lighter and willow tends to be darker. Willow also tends to be more powdery and easier to erase than vine. Nitrum charcoal can hold a point for detail when sharpened. It provides darker and browner shades than both vine or willow charcoal. It's easy to smudge with a hard brush. The Nitrum B is a soft charcoal that produces a rich black. The Nitron HB is a medium charcoal used for homogenizing tones. The Nitron H is the hardest. It can be sharpened to a fine point for detail and light shades. Compressed charcoal is made from charred wood dust, to which a binder is added. The sticks can usually be sharpened with a normal pencil sharpener. Compressed charcoals are very difficult to erase, and they should be reserved for the darkest accents towards the end of the drawing. Pencil extender for your smaller charcoal sticks. Please get one that allows different thicknesses of pencils to be inserted. Sanding block or a sheet of 400 grit sandpaper. These are used to shape the tip of the charcoal. Now I will demonstrate different ways to blend tones. Paper stamps are useful to create a quite uniform blending. Hard brushes will tend to make the smudging even softer. Surprisingly, soft brushes tend to remove more charcoal than hard brushes. Chamois cloth is used for smudging and removing charcoal. Powdered charcoal, which will give a softer look, and it's ideal when toning large areas. It may be used to spread the first layer of tone applied with a brush. It allows you to create expressionistic brush strokes. It is also very easy to erase. With this list of materials, you have everything you need to get started.